Hello everyone. It has been another busy month, and so I wanted to take a moment to share four quick updates with you about some of the progress that is being made. I will begin, of course, with the academic plan, which I'm delighted to report was unanimously approved by Senate on January 18th. This is available now for viewing on the website of the Provost and Vice President Academic. Now, of course, we get to the work of developing implementation plans for each of the 44 actions outlined in the plan, which is something I've now begun doing with units and colleagues across the university. Regular progress updates will be shared with Senate through the Planning Priorities and Budget Advisory Committee. Second, I want to share that I'm also currently working with colleagues in both the Center for Pedagogical Innovation as well as the Office of the Registrar and Enrollment Services on revisions to the quite outdated language in the examinations policy. Potential revisions over here that have all received support from the Undergraduate Student Affairs Committee include adding language to distinguish between on-campus and online exams, empowering faculty to consider the match between their exams and course learning outcomes instead of, for example, requiring department chairs to assess the comparability of exams across multi-section courses, providing guidance related to take-home exams, and revising the submission process for exam scripts from delivery by hand to secure electronic submission. Third, I want to share that, you know, with the growing prominence of ChatGPT, of course, there have been several discussions recently about AI. And I mean this both in terms of artificial intelligence as well as academic integrity. This includes a discussion recently at Senate's Teaching and Learning Policy Committee. Now, in CPI, we recognize, of course, that many instructors will be considering right now how to address these kinds of technologies, whether, for example, being more explicit in assignments about the use of AI, or in some cases, even harnessing these technologies for instructional purposes. Now, CPI is in the process of developing some guidance to support informed decision-making when it comes to ChatGPT in particular. But we do, in the meantime, urge that you carefully consider the privacy and other ethical dimensions of these third-party platforms, especially as we know that they amplify existing societal biases in the text that they've already ingested. And of course, when they do seek to monetize the intellectual property that is submitted to their engines. And finally, I want to take a moment to recognize just a few of the many faculty members at Brock who are leading, in my mind, the push for progressive change and to whom I am grateful for sharing their expertise, their lived experiences, and certainly their time in service of a more inclusive and supportive academy. So I specifically want to thank today Dolana Mogadime, I want to thank Betty Ombuki-Berman, Antone Ayanso, of course, all three of whom who spoke eloquently and powerfully at the recent forum on addressing anti-Black racism that was organized by the Faculty of Applied Health Sciences. I also want to thank Leanne Taylor, whose exceptional research, I'm just going to hold up her latest book over here, on supporting first-generation students is guiding my own thinking and work in this space. Maureen Connolly, who of course is a tireless advocate and known to many of us across the university community, especially when it comes to inclusion and accessibility. And finally, Ebru Ustundag, Amanda Burke, and Lauren Corman, who are all serving now on a new group that's focused on advancing trauma-informed practices across the university. Much more about that soon. But in the meantime, thank you again for your engagement with our supports in CPI, and of course, do not hesitate to reach out either to CPI or even to myself if we can be of service. Thank you.